To make your mark in this arena, you better bring everything you got. This is American Gladiators.
Tonight, Gladiator Arena welcomes four more contenders.
Yeah!
Each of whom has a little something extra to prove against our gladiators.
Let's do this!
After proving to the world that they're tough enough to lose some major weight, 50 pounds, 60 pounds, 65 pounds,
yeah!
100 pounds.
Bring it on! I'm ready for the next round!
They have all remade their lives. Now it's time for the next great challenge.
Jeter!
And it looks like this. And this. And don't forget Helga.
That's right, baby.
Another new gladiator will be revealed. It'll all begin with the most intense game of Powerball ever.
Anytime you can go up with these three ladies, you have sold something.
It's all right here, right now, on American Gladiators. Let's get the skinny on our slim down contenders. First up, James Ruggiero. James is a high school teacher from Yucca Valley, California. He once tipped the scales at 273 pounds. Now, after an incredible 65-pound weight loss, this married father of two comes in at a lean 216. Tonight, James will be going against Sean Hetherington. Not too long ago, this former bartender, originally from Folsom, California, was pushing 270. Now, after an amazing weight loss of more than 100 pounds, Sean has added personal trainer to his resume. At 5'9", 169, he gives away plenty of size to our gladiators, but he's up for the challenge. Let's give him a real challenge with Powerball.
Now, Sean, there's no doubt that 100 pounds ago, you would not have been standing here getting ready to face these gladiators. What would the old Sean say about the new Sean that's standing here today?
100 pounds ago, the old Sean would have said, how did you fit all of this into spandex, for starters? And I'm here today to play the game. Let's do this!
Now, you both know that this is not going to be easy, but something tells me that you guys are not afraid of a challenge, right?
As it goes for challenges, losing 65 pounds was one of the hardest things I ever had to do.
So you have to tell me, what would it feel like to get a victory here?
The victory here tonight means that my two sons, they're going to grow up not saying, I want to be like Mike. They're going to say, I want to be like my father.
All right, well, you have a big old battle ahead of you. Let's bring in the gladiators who want to welcome both of you guys to this competition in their own special way. Here they are! Hurricane!
Go!
Contenders, ready!
Ready!
Gladiators, ready!
Yeah.
3, 2, 1!
Go, 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 go!
James in blue and immediately double-teamed. Sean in red and wall planted by Titan. Boy, the gladiators look really fired up tonight. James double-teamed again. There goes Sean, his first point, and the first point of this Powerball competition.
Come on!
James just blew up Wolf and scored 2 points. Oh, the crowd reeling after that major hit.
You can't do that to me.
Wow, Sean just intimidated by Hurricane. Wolf looking to redeem himself against James. Took him down that time. Sean. Tackled down by Hurricane.
Come on.
Final 10 seconds.
go.
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Contenders running out of gas and running out of time. Game over.
Damn, I'm so sorry.
Good hit.
Even after dropping 60 pounds, James can still throw his weight around. Just ask Wolf.
Now listen, James, you hit Wolf with a pretty big shot out there, and then you made 2 points right in the middle. You had to feel good about that.
You think you're going to go around him, you're not going to go around him. So my only choice was to try to go through him. And once I go through him, there's no more bite left in that little puppy, I'll tell you right now.
Oh, he's a little puppy. All right, Sean, do you think you proved a thing or two to all those people that used to tease you back in your hometown?
I think so. I think anytime you can get in this ring and go up with these three ladies, you have sold something.
Mighty tough talk. You might want to check the scoreboard there, Sean. You're trailing by a point to the big hitting James. Time to meet our fat burning female, starting with Jessica Garcia. This Bronx, New York native reached a peak of 155 pounds before losing a ton of weight. At 4 feet 11 inches tall, this cheerleading coach brings a brand new body and incredible attitude to Gladiator Arena, where she's about to tackle Joust.
Hey, yo, Jessica, you're the first woman up tonight to give it a run. Talk to me about the long road you've traveled all the way from the boogie down Bronx right here to our Gladiator Arena.
You know, I gotta tell you, man, coming from the Bronx, you already come with some energy, you come with some spunk, you come with some fire. I figure why not come to LA and show the world what I have, you know what I'm saying?
Well, after all you've done and losing all the weight you have, what would success mean to you right now in this Gladiator Arena?
You know, my whole entire life, I was a big girl, and to lose all the weight that I lost and get to where I am now, physically, mentally, emotionally, I feel like this is the kind of arena where I can just pull it out. Just to be here right now, this is a success to me. Big.
That's crazy, because the person that's going up against you is the powerful, the beautiful Crush.
The Queen of Joust looks to maintain her domination.
Contender ready!
Yeah!
Gladiator ready!
Yep.
3, 2, 1!
Considering Crush's record in Joust, this shouldn't take long. And look at Crush just taunting the contender. Oh! That was no taunt. That was a major blow. Another one right to the chops. The wheel around. Another big blow. Jessica trying to stay dry and pick up 5 points. Hold on. Crush might have underestimated 4 foot 11 Jessica. Excellent work by the contender.
Hey, little one. You were awesome. What did it feel like up there when the power of Crush was crushing down on top of you and you stood your ground for an eternity and a day?
No, seriously? It was like a freight train hit me, no joke. Every single time, I thought I was going down. Girl, I don't know how people do it up here, but I gotta tell you, this platform is my friend right now. Thank you.
Jessica proving too tough to tame in Joust. If this is any indication of what she's gonna be like, she's gonna be a tough competitor for Patty Franklin. Patty is a 41-year-old nurse and mother of four from Leesburg, Virginia, who dropped 50 pounds after a friend joked about her size at her 20th high school reunion. These days, Patty is a slimmed down 125 pounds. Right now, she's down on the deck with Hulk.
Well, obviously, you're no stranger to just getting up and getting the job done. Are you ready to get the job done now? And considering who you're about to face, are you ready to get it on in our arena?
I am absolutely ready to get it on in this arena, up there on that platform with Joust.
I'm starting to feel that you may have the momentum on your side. Get up there, grab your best hold, good luck on Joust, and we'll see you when the talking and the working's done. Let's hear it, guys, for Joust.
The contender ready!
Ready!
Gladiator ready!
Yep.
3, 2, 1!
Coming up, our newly slim contenders will deal with another huge gladiator debut. The big reveal is on the way. Welcome back to a jam-packed Gladiator Arena. Patty's about to joust with Crush, who may have something to prove after Jesse went the distance.
Is the contender ready?
Ready!
Gladiator ready?
Yep.
3, 2, 1.
Crush not playing around this time. Immediately going for the kill. And she's got it! Patty is all wet as Crush celebrates another win in Joust. In the battle of former heavyweights, Jessica with a 5-0 lead over Patty.
All right, time to let the guys swing for the fences. Sean, you're up first. I know that you watched a lot of American Gladiators when you were a kid. Is there anything that you learned back then that you're going to bring to this game today?
The same thing I learned from watching you. Training, saying my prayers, eating my vitamins, and believing in myself.
At this point, I'd say you better focus on saying your prayers, brother, because standing behind you is the unbelievable, the unstoppable Toa. Woo-hoo!
Toa doesn't want to hear about how much weight you lost. He just wants to beat you down.
Is the contender ready? Gladiator ready? 3, 2, 1.
Sean probably wishing he had a little bit more weight to him as he goes up against Toa. Uh-oh, Sean looks like he's in trouble. He is. Toa says, roll me another one.
I'm 165 pounds, Toa's 250 plus the dress. So I think I did okay, all things considering.
At 6'2", 215 pounds, James could be a very even match for Toa.
Is the contender ready?
Ready.
Gladiator ready?
Ready.
3, 2, 1.
And it is an even match, right? No! Wow! Look at James rock and roll! Big James enjoying a low-carb, high-protein diet by making a meal of Toa. Look at the domination. After only two events, James already with a 12-1 lead over Sean. We head back out over the water as the women get ready for the always frantic hit and run.
You right now. You don't want to play catch up too long. You think you can score some points here?
I'm hoping I could score some points here. I'm a nurse, so I work well under pressure. I think I'm going to do fine.
Well, let's introduce you to the gladiators that are going to be trying to knock you right back into the water. Jet! Woo! Helga! Siren! Woo! And Venom!
Yeah! Woo! She's going down! Woo!
Contender, ready!
Ready!
Gladiators, ready!
Ready! Ready!
3, 2, 1!
60 seconds for the contenders to try to make it back and forth across this 50-foot bridge, all the while dodging those 100-pound demolition balls.
Come on, girl!
Venom full of challenge for Patty. Jet with the toss.
Both diamonds together.
4 points for Patty. Siren trying to time her pitch, as was Jet. But Patty outran all of them.
Come on, guys.
Jet. Oh, that was close. Time running out on Patty. She's got 8 points. Can she make it back across to hit 10?
Come on.
Patty showed she still has an appetite for hit and run, working hard for 8 big points. Now, let's see how Jess can move at a tiny 4 feet 11 inches tall.
Is the contender ready?
Yeah!
Gladiators ready?
Ready!
3, 2, 1!
You know, those gladiators are looking for blood after Patty scored 8 points.
Be on your feet.
Jet had Jess in her sights. Helga trying to get it with the comebacker, but Jess scores her first 2 points. There goes Jet again. Points for Jess. Look out! Venom with the curveball working. Oh, and she just did miss Helga's demolition ball.
Oh,
Jessica doing great on time and already matching Patty's 8-point total. She's got a great chance to get 10 and maybe even 12. Jet's got her. Oh, look out! Jet did get her. She may be leaner and lighter, but Jessica's still a big enough target for Jet. Despite taking a bath, Jessica still has a 5-point lead over Patty. The men have been saying no to onion rings, and now it's time for our slimmed down contenders to taste a new set of rings on Hang Top.
Time to make the turn from the ladies hitting and running to the guys flat out hanging tough. Sean, we know that you studied gladiators when you were growing up as a kid, but the strategy didn't help you any on Joust. Is it gonna be any different here?
My strategy on Hang Tough is to not die and to make it all the way across. That's the only strategy I have today.
Well, here's the gladiator who's gonna bring back his ugliest memories of Hang Tough. Give it up for the awesome Fang-bearing Wolf!
Even after losing 100 pounds, Sean still has enough meat on his bones for Wolf.
Wolf's going down!
Yeah, Wolf!
Going down, Wolf!
Is the contender ready?
Ready!
Gladiator ready?
Oh, yeah.
3, 2, 1!
Coming up! A brand new gladiator is sprung from her cage. The ferocious reveal is next. Welcome back to Gladiator Arena. Let's step inside as Sean prepares to take a stand against Wolf on Hang Tough.
Is the contender ready?
Ready.
Gladiator ready?
Oh, yeah.
3, 2, 1.
Got to get your rhythm going when you're in Hang Tough. Sean looks a little tentative, and Wolf looks mighty hungry. Wolf wastes little time. See ya!
Yeah!
Wolf has no problem sinking his claws into Sean and sending him down into the ice cold drink.
James is up next. Yo, James, after Sean's effort right here, you've still got an 11-point lead, but you've also got a real pumped-up Wolf coming at you, especially after that encounter you two had on Powerball when you went nose-to-nose. Are you worried he may have a little something special for you up there on Hang Tough, brother?
Look, Hulk, as far as I'm concerned, he's the gladiator formerly known as Wolf.
Let the games begin! Ha!
Is the contender ready?
Game time!
Gladiator ready?
Oh!
3, 2, 1!
Wolf is as angry and as fired up as I've ever seen him. goes in for the kill. Oh!
Wolf with the big gamble move, and James still has plenty of time to make it all the way across to the other platform. Reckless behavior by Wolf, and it cost him. James with 10 big points.
It's a marriage, baby!
Wow! For the second time in the competition, Wolf on the losing end of a battle with James. As we check the scoreboard, James with the commanding 21-point lead over Sean. Now it's time for the women to take it to the skies in Rocketball.
It's time for our ladies to light the fuse and blast off. Patty, did you ever dream you'd be doing something like this when you got the call to come down and be a contender?
No, I didn't. I had no idea that I was going to be rocketed to the ceiling. It's a tough competition. Jessica's been ahead of me the whole time. This is the event that I plan to take her in.
I love it. Hey, yo, Jess. At 4'11", you're used to working close to the ground. What's the point of you going to be, like, way up there for you?
I gotta tell you, my whole entire life, I've wondered what it was like to be up high, you know? And this is when I get to do it. America gets to watch me get tossed up in the sky. Let's do it, baby.
I love it. Well, let's bring in the gladiators who want to make every part of your flight a painful memory. Please say hello to the awesome Phoenix.
Phoenix, always ready to rise to the occasion.
And now, gladiator maniacs, I want you to help me welcome our next gladiator to the arena floor for the very first time. Get on your feet and make some noise for the absolutely fearless Panther.
This is one ferocious feline.
Let's do this, baby!
Are the contenders ready?
Yeah!
Gladiators ready?
Ready!
3, 2, 1.
You really need to time your launches. And Jessica already trying to fake out Phoenix with the pushing of the red button.
Oh, there you go. Oh!
Oh, really playing a cat and mouse game, and it's paying off for Jessica. She scores the first point. There goes Patty. Oh! The Panther is ready to pounce. Jessica doing a great job with timing of her launches. A 2-1 rocket ball game. 3-1. Jessica in control. Panther with another big hit. Another bruising blow by Panther. Oh. 10 seconds left.
Right.
Look at that timing of the launch by Jessica. Outstanding. Jessica had plenty of reason to celebrate as her hand fakes did the trick to earn her the victory with 4 big points. Patty, on the other hand, found out how much our newest gladiator loves to hit. So far, our slimmest contender is out to a fat lead, 17-9. Coming up, the challenge continues for our slim down contenders. They'll pull with all their might on snapback. Can they send a gladiator flying? Plus, losing weight is one thing. Surviving the brutal eliminator is another. The obstacle course from hell is coming up when American Gladiators returns. Welcome back to Gladiator Arena, where the men have battled hard in every event. And as they prep for their final showdown, we'll catch you up on all the action. Sean finally got back on the scoreboard during Rocketball, soaring against Militia and Zen for 4 important points. Too bad for him, James flew off with 9 points and gave the crowd a big show in the process. Unfortunately, both contenders shut out on Earthquake. James gave Titan a fight before getting thrown into our 200,000-gallon pool. Sean? Well, not so much. To see the events in their entirety, head to NBC.com. With one event to go before the Eliminator, James is cruising with a 26-point lead on Sean. Can our personal trainer trim the fat on that fat lead? Let's find out on Snapback. James will be going up against the mighty Toa, who's out for revenge after getting beat on Joust. Sean will have to contend with the Hurricane. Before he pulls against Sean, let's take a look at Hurricane's Subway stat card.
Let's go!
This world-class athlete, an Olympic javelin thrower, had a very impressive gladiator debut when he tore into the arena and toyed with our contenders on Tilt. He followed that with a splash on Hit and Run.
Yeah!
When Hurricane gets fired up, he'll blow you away. For more on Hurricane and all our gladiators, including news on how they fuel up and power on by building their favorite Subway sub, go to NBC.com. Now, it's time for Snapback.
Are the contenders ready?
Ready.
Gladiators ready? Three, two, one.
Remember, the goal in Snapback is to fight the resistance being provided by the gladiators and hit that red button. Oh, James launches Toa. There he goes. Sean is still in it against Hurricane.
Come on, come on.
He's got to dig deep.
Come on. Come on.
Look at James cheering on his competition.
Come on.
But Sean comes up empty, 0 points. Fantastic sportsmanship displayed by James. James made Toa weightless and becomes the first contender to launch a gladiator in Snapback. James extends his lead over Sean to 36 points. That'll give him a huge 18-second head start in Eliminator. As the guys prepare for their final showdown, we catch you up on all the women's action. There was only one story to tell on Tilt. Steel, our silent assassin, dropped Jessica into the icy water in just 14 seconds. Once Patty started pulling, it looked like she might go the distance. But in the end, Steel just too tough. Skytrack, just as brutal on our contenders. Crush caught up to Jessica. And Siren sank Patty, leaving both women bobbing in midair without earning a single point. To see these events in their entirety, head to NBC.com. That leaves us here, 17-9 in Jessica's favor. Now it's the women's turn to take on Snapback as Jessica faces the mighty Phoenix, while Patty takes on the awesome Helga.
Are the contenders ready?
Yeah!
Gladiators ready?
Oh, yeah!
Three, two, one!
Boy, you gotta get low and dig deep if you're a contender. Jessica with the mighty challenge taking on Phoenix. Time running out on the contenders. They can still score some points. Oh, they're reaching and reaching, trying to get as far as they can. Jessica ends up with 4 points. Patty will settle for two. Sorry, Patty. You can pull and pull, but you just can't make a dent in Helga.
Jesse, Patty, that looked grueling. I got tired just watching. Tell me what it was like.
That was pretty hard. You kind of get that head start, and then all of a sudden you feel like you're trying to drag a mountain, and it's not moving.
Heading into the Eliminator, Jessica with the commanding 10-point lead over Patty. That'll be good for a 5-second head start. These contenders have shown they've got the dedication to drop serious weight, but do they have what it takes to survive the Eliminator? We'll find out next. Welcome back to Gladiator Arena, where it's time for a fantastic finish. Only one thing stands between our contenders and triumph. It is the Eliminator.
Welcome to the Eliminator. And as a guy who hates to see anyone suffer, I feel bad knowing what Sean and James are about to go through. But as they say, no pain, no gain. In this case, they could gain a shot at the next round in anything but ordinary 2008 Toyota Sequoia and $100,000. James, who rode a 60-pound weight loss into the arena, brings in an amazing 36-point lead over Sean, who lost more than 100 pounds. That gives him an 18-second head start. Yo, Sean, you and I both know that's gonna be hard to overcome. Aside from what you're about to face, what was the most difficult part about competing here at the arena?
Trying to act like I wasn't terrified of those big, beefy gladiators in front of me. Those are the scariest people I've ever seen. But now I'm gonna go under the water and through the Eliminator and come out, and it's gonna be a bigger comeback than Mariah Carey.
I love it, brother. James, for you as a big man, what have you learned about yourself going up against Sean and all the gladiators?
No one could ever tell me no. No one could ever tell me that I can't do something. But when I gained a lot of weight and people said, you're not gonna lose that weight, well, I lost the weight anyway, and I'm here to prove more people wrong and come out on top, that a big man can post the best time.
The talking's over. It's time for action. Let's hear it for Sean, for James, and the awesome Eliminator.
Go on my first whistle. Sean, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
James into the water. What a huge advantage he will have. An 18-second head start over Sean. Sean is released. So let's see if he can stage the biggest comeback since Mariah Carey. No matter how this Eliminator competition pans out, both of these contenders have to feel fantastic. Sean has lost 100 pounds. James has lost 65 pounds. Who would have ever thought these two gentlemen would be competing in American Gladiators? Sean giving it his all as he makes the 30-foot climb up the cargo net. James onto the hand bike. Makes it across. Now down the rolling pin for James. Oh, nice landing. Sean just now to the top of the cargo net. James racing against the clock. As he takes on the teeter-totter. But don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, the Travelator is still ahead for James. Sean hanging in there, holding on to hope as James attacks that Travelator. Oh, look at him! In his first attempt, no problem whatsoever. James grabs the rope and busts through and posts a winning time of 2:07.
Yeah! Yeah! There we go. That's your dad right there. That is your dad.
Come on up, Big James. The beast coming out of the blue water, dude. You are the man, brother. You told me what you were gonna do the moment you looked me in the eye. You dominated, you ran over every gladiator that was in your way. How does it feel to dominate and be here in the victory circle?
It feels absolutely amazing to set your mind to a goal and achieve that goal. But for me, I'm only halfway there. That's just part one. I got a whole sequel coming, more of this. I gotta get better, bigger, stronger, faster. You can never, ever be satisfied. You can always do better.
I've never seen a big man put a 2:07 time down on the Eliminator like that. That was unbelievable.
I'll tell you what, it makes it real easy for me to shoot for something. I gotta get it down under two, way under two.
Come here, Big Sean. Congratulations, tremendous job, brother. You proved to everybody in this building that you would finish what you started, and you won over the hearts of everybody in this arena. How do you feel right now, brother?
I can't believe that I lost 100 pounds and I was able to get through this.
Brother, we are all so proud of you, man.
Checking the leaderboard, we remind you only the 6 fastest winning eliminator times move on to the semifinals. Right now, with that impressive time of 2:07, James in good shape. Coming up, it doesn't play favorites, and it definitely doesn't care how much weight you may have lost. The women face the brutality of the eliminator. Next. Welcome back to Gladiator Arena. These biggest losers turned biggest bruisers have shown the world what they're made of. Now they have to prove it one more time on Eliminator.
Now, Jesse, you padded your lead on snapback with 10 points, which gives you a 5-second head start. You've seen what Patty's made of. Are you comfortable with your lead?
Yeah, I'm comfortable with a 5-second lead. I gotta tell you what, though. I'm just looking ahead all the way through till I crash through that paper. And 5 seconds, 10 seconds, it doesn't matter. That's my goal right there, baby.
Now, Patty, tell me what's going through your mind. All that's left now to face is Jesse and the Eliminator.
I think at this point, I've made it through the hard part. I know I'm gonna see Jesse's back for the first 5 seconds, but I don't think that's gonna last for long.
Well, I like how that sounds. You guys ready to give these ladies some support?
Are the contenders ready? Jessica, you will go on my first whistle. Patty, you will go on my second whistle. 3, 2, 1.
Jessica, out of the Bronx, New York. Patty, a mother of 4 from Virginia. Both these ladies have lost more than 50 pounds each. Look at Patty take the lead in the underwater swim and attack the cargo net. Wow! All of a sudden, we've got a fantastic race. You can see the determination on their faces, the same kind of determination that was necessary for both these ladies to fight through their weight loss. Jessica grabs the rope swing first. Patty close behind. Oh! That could be trouble for Patty. There she's across. Oh, Jessica loses her grip on the handbike. This could be an opportunity for Patty. Now Patty takes on the handbike. If she can make it across, she could retake the lead. She does. She goes down the rolling pin. Oh! Patty slips off the rolling pin, and now Jessica ready to retake the lead. Look at this fantastic eliminator competition. Neck and neck. Down the zip line they go as Patty pulls slightly ahead. Oh, tough landing. Oh, tough landing again. What a fantastic race this is. Now you know how these ladies were able to lose all that weight. The Travelator is the equalizer. Both ladies attack, and both ladies retreat. Oh, Jessica holding on for dear life. She's got her feet. She's keeping her feet underneath her. Can she hold on to get to the top? Oh, she's so close. Oh, Patty has an opportunity. Patty, using her feet. Can she pull herself up? Oh, so close. Inching, inching up. She's through. Patty is through. She's ascending the stairs. She loses all that weight and wins the competition.
Patty! Patty! Patty!
so hard. Oh my God, it's definitely hard. You power through again with your legs and your feet go, and you don't even know if you have the energy to do it again.
Don't forget, only the top six winning eliminator times are good enough for the semifinals. Patty had enough to beat Jessica, but not enough to make the top six. Patty and James proved to us all that they are anything but ordinary by first losing more than 50 pounds, then plowing through the eliminator on to victory. It's our Toyota Sequoia winning moment we can all take to heart.
Tonight, you took that same focus and drive that you used to lose all that weight and turned it into a performance to remember, girl.
Gladiator Maniacs, get on your feet and give it up for James and Patty. Let's hear it.
Next week, American Gladiators returns with a battle for the ages as a 20-year-old ball of fire from Boston squares off with the oldest contender ever to hit Gladiator Arena.
You could be my grandma, baby.
And if you think our Gladiators are going to take it easy on a sweet little 52-year-old, think again.
That wasn't very nice to pick on a little old lady like me.
Plus, an Army veteran who went from Afghanistan to training dolphins.
Right here, right now. Woo!
Takes on an All-American camp counselor out to set a few land speed records.
I've got to prove that I'm the man and that I can take it!
And don't forget our army of ferocious gladiators. More hits, more action, more of everything you love.
Energy and power for Yoko!
And it all comes to a head in an Eliminator Showdown you'll be talking about all week. That's next Monday, 8, 7 Central on American Gladiators!